integrals. Find integral x squared divided by 1 minus x raised to 4 dx. So here we have to find the value of the given integral, that is integral of x squared divided by 1 minus x raised to 4 dx. Okay, at first what we are going to do is we are just rewriting this denominator, that is 1 minus x raised to 4, as 1 minus x squared whole square. Okay. Then in the next step, what is this? This is in the form a square minus b square, that is a plus b into a minus b. That is, we are going to simplify this denominator in the next step. So that is 1 minus x square whole square is a square minus b square, and which is rewritten as 1 minus x square into 1 plus x square, that is a plus b into a minus b. So we have a 1 plus x square here. In order to form our numerator in the terms of 1 plus x square, we are doing another trick here, that is we are adding a 1 to the numerator and subtracting a 1 to the numerator. Okay, so why we are doing this? Because we need this term here, that is 1 plus x square. In the next step, we are splitting the numerator into 2, that is the terms into 2, that is 1 plus x square divided by 1 minus x square into 1 plus x square minus 1 whole divided by 1 minus x square into 1 plus x square dx. That is, we are just splitting this numerator as two terms here. Then in the next step, we are rearranging this term as 1 by 2 into 1 minus x square dx plus 1 by 2 by 1 plus x square dx. How we are doing this is by this method, that is, at first we are making this terms in the form of partial fractions. That is, we are just putting the value of x square as t. Then, since we have two variables available here, is x square in the denominator, we can easily put x square equal to t here. Then we will get our denominator as 1 minus t, that is 1 minus x square will turn into 1 minus t, and 1 plus x square will turn into 1 plus t. Then we are making it in the term form of the partial fraction, that is a by 1 minus t plus b by 1 plus t. Then next step is to find what is the value of a and b here. That is, we are going to represent this 1 minus x square into 1 plus x square as the sum of two terms whose one of whose denominator is 1 minus x square, another is 1 plus x square. That is, we will represent 1 equal to 1 by 2 plus 1 by 2. In like that way, we are representing this as in the terms of 1 minus x square and 1 plus x square. Okay. So for finding the value of a and b, we are just multiplying each and every term by 1 minus t into 1 plus t. Then what will remain here? 1. Now by multiplying a into 1 minus t into 1 plus t, 1 minus t get cancelled. Then what we will get? A into 1 plus t. Then again by multiplying 1 minus t into 1 plus t, 1 plus t get cancelled, and we will get b into 1 minus t here. Now, for finding the value of a and b, put t equal to 1. Then, if t equal to 1, then what will happen? B will become 0. Then, what is this? 1 equal to 2a, or a equal to 1 by 2. Again, if we put t equal to minus 1, then a will get 0. That is, the term with a will get 0. That 1 plus minus 1 became 0. And what about b? 1 minus minus 1 became 2. That is, 1 equal to 2b, and b will become 1 by 2. So we get a equal to 1 by 2 and b equal to 1 by 2. What is b? X square. So we are rearranging this term as 1 by 2 by 1 minus t. Then 1 by 2 by 1 minus t is 1 minus x square, and 1 by 2 by 1 plus t, that is 1 plus x square. Now just integrating this term, we can find our answer. And before that, consider we have here two terms with the denominator 1 minus x square, that is 1 by 1 minus x square dx, and here 1 by 2 by 1 minus x square dx, that is 1 minus of 1 by 1 minus x square, and this will become half into, that is 1 minus half will become half into integral of 1 minus x square dx plus half into integral of 1 plus x square dx. Then what is integral of 1 minus x square dx? We can utilize this formula, that is integral of 1 by a square minus x square equal to 1 by 2a into log mod log mod a plus x divided by a minus x plus c. Utilizing that formula, we will get log mod 1 plus x by 1 minus x. Then what about this? Integral of a square plus x square equal to 1 by a tan inverse of x by a. Utilizing that formula, we will get tan inverse of x plus c. Here a equal to 1 and here also a equal to 1. So this is our required answer.